Same topic of causality. So last week and the previous yesterday we discussed some profound points about related to causality. So today's lecture will be regarding the rudimentary fundamentals that governs the theory of causality in Theravada Buddhism. The topic was given rudimentary fundamentals of the philosophy of causality advocated by the Theravadins. So these are can be said as the very basic notions of causality within the Theravada tradition. So the very basic notion is, when we normally say cause is the paccaya, effect is the paccayuppanna, and also we mentioned any Dhamma, nature can be a cause, whether it's a reality, something related to a reality, concept or unconditioned reality, all can be causes. But when it comes to Pachyupannas, they have to be always realities, conditioned realities. In terms of numbers, 89 Chittas, 52 Chetasikas, they are associated, and 18 Nippana Rupas. So the next theory is always cause and effect, paccaya and paccayuppanna, can never be the same. That is the number 9.13 what I have given. A very basic notion of the causality of Theravadins is the cause and the effect can never be the same. They are always different. If a cause and the effect is the same, because cause supports the effect, if the cause and the effect are the same, the reality supports itself. Is self-dependent. So this is against the Buddhist theory. So therefore, cause and effect are always, always different from each other. They can never be the same. They can exist together, but in terms of reality, it cannot be the same. That is a very basic theory. So it is true that the effects depend upon causes, but it doesn't mean that the effect of paccayuppanna can be reduced into causes. For example, some scholars tend to say, if something is made out of cause, now for example we say paramattha dhammas are irreducible elements of the existence. They cannot be divided any further. For example, the chair, the conceptual idea, is subject to analysis. So when you divide we can bring the chair into pieces, particles, and in the end we can come to the four great elements. So chair is liable to analysis, intellectual analysis. So concepts, if something can be divided into two, at least it is a concept, it can never be a reality. Reality is not liable to intellectual analysis. So someone can argue, if a reality depends on causes, doesn't it mean that reality can be put into causes? No, causes are different, reality is the effect is different. So even though something depends on causes, it doesn't mean it can be reduced into causes. Cause means the support reality gains for its arising, sustaining generations, growth and so forth. So therefore, causes are not the substances of the effects. So that was the second paragraph says. It is a part of the basic fundamental. Albeit the fact that the effects depend upon relevant causes for their arising, sustaining in generation, growth, to remain uneducated and to remain in a state of being capable of yielding results. I gave five explanations because we know there are various types of upada. Effects cannot be reduced into its causes. Always causes are different from their effects and vice versa. So that is a very basic fundamental. Number one. Then we go to the number two fundamental, 19.14. Conditioned realities can never sustain by their own power. That is another very basic theory. They can never sustain. Conditioned realities can never sustain by their own power. They are not self-sustained. It means reality can never arise, sustain in generation, grow, remain uneradicated, and remain in the state of being capable of yielding results without the assistance of another reality. So therefore, always conditioned realities are depending upon others. That is also a very basic theory. If something depends upon itself, that is a characteristic of a self, self-depending. So always the conditioned realities are supported by other realities. Yes.
What reason? There must be
that. No, that is observation. That is what we see in the reality. If something arises, means it has to be depending on something. It is impossible that another point is, now for example, if something arises, it means it should always have a support prior to that. It will always have a support prior to that. So therefore, always, if something arises out of nothing means without existing before, it means it has the support of another reality. That is the conditioned nature, if something is conditioned. So then all the conditioned realities need the assistance of a paccaya, which had occurred or existed or have been existing before its arising. Another very basic fundamental. If an effect happens, if pachupanna arises, always we have to find there should be something, some reality which has existed before it. Either it has already existed and passed away, or it is still existing, but it has occurred before the pachupanna. That is also a must. It means sometimes we call about sahajata paccaya, supporting each other together while arising together. Sahajata paccaya is not relevant enough for a reality to happen. Always, always there should be a support which has already occurred or existed before. A chitta and chetsikas which arise as a chittaja rupa, chittupada and cluster of chitta chetsikas, need the support of the immediately preceding chitta chuttupada chitta yesika. That's why chitta needs the support of the preceding chitta. Rupas either need the support of the past kamma or tejo dhatu, that is utuja rupas, oja aharja rupas which has arisen before, or a generation rupas which has occurred before, rupa santati. Rupas also need a reality which has happened before it. So kammaja rupas are produced by a kamma which has occurred before. Then utuja rupas are produced by the tejo dhatu which has occurred before. Oja rupa is produced, aharaja rupa is produced by the oja which has occurred before. A question can come regarding chittaja rupas. Some may say chittaja rupas are produced by chitta at this their arising moment. So what I am saying may seems to be contradicting. So because the main cause of the chitta rupas is the chitta, and they arise together at the same time. But also we also need to consider chitta rupas cannot arise unless there has been a rupa generation which has occurred before. Chitta rupas arise on a place where rupa has already occurred. So therefore, whatever condition reality, condition is necessary which has occurred before. Without the support of a reality which has occurred before, which has been existing before, conditioned realities, pachyupannas can never occur. So it's a very basic theory. With related to this fundamental, one may have a question about chitta rupas. It is not that Chittadrupas are produced by the causes which are arising together with them. That is to say the Chitta and Chetasikas. Yes, the main reason for Chittadrupas are the co-arising Chitta and Chetasikas which produce them. But consciousness and mental factors are unable to produce mind-born matter if there is no generation of rupas that have arisen before them. That is the reason why 46 chittas that arise in arupa realm do not produce any chittajarupas. So therefore, in our life, first the kambajarupa is produced at the moment of patisandhi. Then from the next moment, bhavanga chitta produces chittajarupa. These rupas are produced because it also has the support of a previously arisen matter. So that is what the commentary says. It has to have a rupa saptati, rupa santati sisa should be there. A rupa process which had occurred before should be there. So therefore, a very basic fundamental is for a reality to happen, occur, there should be some realities which has occurred before it. So that is also a very basic fundamental. So three fundamentals we discussed. Cause and effect are always different. Even though a cause effect depends on cause, it doesn't mean the effect can be reduced into causes. They are different elements, different things. Conditioned realities can never sustain by its own power. That is one. And also, a conditioned reality always needs the support of something which has occurred before its arising. Then, there is no Pachyupanna which does not need the support of conditioned realities for its arising. Conditioned realities are always supported by conditioned realities. Sometimes they get the support of Nibbana and Panyatti, but there is no conditioned reality which can only occur based on Nibbana and Panyatti. Always, conditioned realities needs the support of other conditioned realities. Chitta needs the support of a Chitta which has occurred before. Chetasikas are the same. Rupa needs the four types of Kamma, Chitta, Utu, Ahara. Sometimes because of the training rules the Buddha lays down, we practice Sila, but still we put effort. But these Chittas also need the support of other Chittas. So therefore, it is not that any conditioned reality arises only based on Nibbana or Panyatti. So therefore, another basic fundamental is, if something is a conditioned reality, it is supported by causes. Those causes should have some conditioned realities. So causes of an effect, conditioned reality, should be conditioned realities. It may include unconditioned realities in some cases, but not always. But it is impossible that a conditioned reality arises without the support of conditioned realities. That is another very basic fundamental. There is no Pachyupanna which does not need the support of conditioned realities for its arising, sustaining generation, growth, to remain uneradicated and remain in the state of being capable in producing results. Sometimes Nibbana and Panyatti can become causes for other realities. But there is no reality which depends only on Nibbana, only on Panyatti, or only on both. It means realities which gain the support of Nibbana and Panyatti are required to obtain assistance of conditioned realities as well. Right, this is the fourth fundamental I would like to introduce. The next fundamental, number five. All Pachyupannas arise together with some other realities. To which, it means, in other words, if I say it precisely, conditioned realities arise in clusters. It means there is no conditioned reality which arises alone. That is a very basic fundamental. Always they arise in clusters with the support of others. So that support they gain from their co-arising realities is called Sahajata Pachya. So they appear in clusters. Chitta, Chetasikas appear in clusters. We call this Chittupada. Rupa appears in clusters. We call it Rupa Kalapa. So always they arise in clusters of reality. This is another very basic one. Whatever arises, Nibbana is not a cluster. Nibbana is an unconditioned state. But conditioned realities always need arise in clusters. Moreover, a reality is a reality cluster. In a reality cluster, So reality, not reality show, reality in a reality cluster, always get the assistance of some realities within the same cluster. Not from all, but from some. Right? So that is called Sahajata Pachya. So they, sometimes they interdepend, but sometimes some realities support others, but the others doesn't support them. So, but at least some would, all would get the support of some reality. Then there's another point. Then Theravadis advocate the causality of Nana Hetu and Nana Phala. It's a very important point. So, this is like, this is regarding other doctrines. When we talk about certain doctrines, especially the creation of God and so forth, when we say Hetu Phala, Hetu is cause, Pachya, also called Hetu. It's called Phala. So sometimes they say Eka Hetu, Eka Phala. Eka Hetu, Eka Phala. It means whatever in the, it means one cause is there, out of that one effect happens. Right? There can be such doctrines. That is one theory. In such there can be some doctrines. Another theory is, now this Eka Hetu, Eka Phala have two explanations. One cause is producing all the other effects. Right? Eka Hetu, Eka Phala. Sometimes you can say a great Atman brings out all the remaining Atmans, something like that. What? So another way I was explaining is, one cause is only supporting another effect. One cause is, for example, avidya supports sankhara. Avidya doesn't support any other, only sankhara. So this is also not advocated by Buddhism. There is no cause that only supports one reality. So that is one point. There's, so only one reality only gains the one reality, one pachupanna gain the support of one cause. There is no such a thing. So one to one is not found in Theravada. We say Theravada itself, it's not possible. Then we have Eka Hetu Nana Phala. Pachupanna is Nana. Nana is many. Nana is many. For example, the one ultimate God, who is the real cause for everything, created the entire world. Beings, animals, humans, animated, inanimated things, water, fire, everything. But one cause. Everything springs out from this ultimate God. It's called Eka Hetu Nana Phala. Buddhism doesn't advocate this. And also, beyond doesn't say, for example, avijja produces sankhara, tanha, moha and so forth. But all these various pachyupannas gain the support of only avijja. It means there are some pachyupannas which gains the support of only one cause. There is no such a thing. It means in Buddhism, it's not doctrinal wise we can say one cause produces like God producing everything. But within Buddhism even, we don't say avijja, for example, sankhara, vijnana, sankhara, tanha, upadana, they all get the support only of avijja. We don't say like that. So therefore, there is no theory in Buddhism, since Theravada doesn't accept the idea, Eka Hetu, one cause supporting many, many, many effects. Then we have Nana Hetu Eka Phala. Nana Hetu Eka Phala means, Nana Hetu Eka Phala means many causes producing just one effect. There can be a doctrine for such, but in if you go to the causal theory, for example, we take sankhara. Sankhara is produced by, for example, we can say tanha, avijja, upadana. They all produce sankhara. Only sankhara, nothing other than that. Avijja, some few causes come together and produce only one effect. We don't advocate this.
these also are not accepted. Theravada has advocated nana phala, nana hetu, nana phala. This is what Theravada suggests.
It means always a reality, pachyupanna, get the support of many causes. Many causes support one pachyupanna. One pachyupanna supports many. So likewise, always, if we focus on one reality, it is supported by many. If you consider about one cause, it supports many pachyupannas. So likewise, when one incident happens, there are many causes and many effects. For example, the previous chitta chetasikas, chitta plus chetasikas, support the following chitta and chetasikas. This is the causes. These are the effects. This is eka or nana. There are many causes supporting many effects. It is not that one cause supporting one. When incident happened, one such incidents happen. Incident means arising of a reality. It doesn't happen, no one reality arises alone. Cluster of realities. So likewise, so this is like nana hetu nana phala. Many causes supporting many effects. So that is what the teachings of the Theravadins are. Nana hetu nana phalavada. So then someone have a question. So in Paticchasamuppada, Buddha has explained. Avijja paccaya sankhara, sankhara paccaya vijnana. One cause, one effect. That is because of few reasons. One is padhana, because of main reason. Pakata, because of very evident reason. Another asadharana, because of the uncommon reason. So there are three reasons why we say one cause, one effect. In the doctrinal wise, we say. Because of padhana, main. Pakata, conspicuous or prominent, very obvious. Then asadharana. I haven't given it in the handout. Asadharana is unique. Right? These are the three reasons why we say one cause, one theory. One cause, one effect theory. Why we advocate it. But natural, in the nature, we say many causes producing many effects. But the theory is given, offered to us as one cause, one effect. If you look into Paticchasamuppada, Buddha mentioned avijja causes sankhara, sankhara causes vijnana. So one cause, one effect. So this is because of reason. Like for example, sankhara is produced by avijja. That is padhana, main. Why? Because avijja, sankhara needs the support of tanha, upadana and so forth for it to happen. But these upadana, tanha also are needed, supported by avijja. So avijja is the main. That is called padhana. It is the cause for, even for the cause, like sankhara has the cause of tanha. Tanha has the cause of avijja. So it's called the padhana naya. Sometimes it's the very obvious. So why beings do unwholesome deeds? Because they don't know the results of these deeds. Why beings start to perform good deeds and to wishing to be born in good realms? Because they don't know the suffering of these realms. So therefore, sankhara, we put effort, we yield effort, we try to create something in the new lives, for coming lives, because we don't know the, understand the suffering. It is big, sometimes okay because of craving, but because mainly it's because of not understanding. That is why the craving is also present. So therefore, Buddha mentions, avidva, the one who doesn't know, abhisankharanti, he strives to get good results in future. So good results means pleasurable results in future. So likewise, these teachings were given because of some reasons. But in the actuality, Theravadins advocate that nana hetu nana phala theory. That is a very important another fundamental. So far we have discussed few fundamentals. First one is, if I revise again, that we decide cause and effect can never be the same. Effect can never be reduced to cause. That is one fundamental. Second fundamental, condition realities can never sustain by their own. And also third fundamental, realities need the support of a condition that has occurred before. then there is no pachyupanna which does not need the support of conditioned realities. So always conditioned realities need the support of another conditioned reality. So always pachyupannas, conditioned realities arise in clusters. They get the sahajata pachya of these clusters. So up to that we got five fundamentals. Sixth fundamental is nana hetu, nana phala. It's always many causes supporting many effects. So that's number six. Number seven, the ability of a pachya to support a pachyupanna is called the pachya sati. The ability of a pachya, cause produces effect. Cause producing effect. It means pachya. So what is the ability of the pachya to produce pachyupanna? Why is it? Because it has a certain ability. This ability is called pachya sati. In some places we call it rasa. Pachya sati is something which is in the pachya, a quality, attribute of the pachya. So it is, but it is not a separate ultimate reality. So therefore, it is not a separate ultimate reality. So therefore, we don't define it as a separate entity. Sometimes the pachya itself is explained as the pachya sati is explained as the pachya itself. But some explanations we say the pachya sati of the pachya is the attribute of the pachya. So that is why we can divide certain pachyas have certain attributes like hetu pachya, aramana pachya, adhipati pachya. They have different attributes. So this is the, how to say, pachya sati we call. The ability of the pachya to produce its results. Sometimes it's called rasa. Sometimes it is called rasa. This rasa has few meanings. The word rasa. Lakkana rasa pachupattana padattana. It has few meanings. One is the pachya sati. So, in very basic level, pachya sati means the attitha that we explained last time. Attitha, the nature of existing, is the real pachya sati. For example, if we take the avijja, avijja has its own attribute, own characteristic. Sankhara has its own characteristic. So their existence, nature of existence, maybe in the latent level, maybe with the ability to produce results like Kamma Samangita, or in the level of arising, in the state of arising, exist, persisting or passing away. So whatever, in whatever level, their existence, attita, is the main pachya sati. So when, for example, we say ear consciousness arises because of ear, the existence of ear itself is the main reason for the arising of ear consciousness. So therefore this attita, the existing nature, is the main pachya sati of the pachya. If something is like it's found there, it's existing nature, then the remaining qualities are, for example, if you go into 24 pachyas, we have specific pachya satis. Though these pachya satis are the, how to say, some attributes of this quality, existing quality. So therefore, pachya sati, when we say pachya sati, the main pachya sati is its existing nature, the quality of existing. Then it's the remaining pachya forces, what we find in 24 pachyas, are attributes of this existing nature. So therefore, pachya sati is the ability of the pachya to produce the pachyupanna. Then the next condition, fundamental, number 8, 9.20. A conditioned reality possesses a certain ability to exist. I think last time, yesterday, Isyali asked the question, the ability to exist, right? So, I think I should share the answer I gave at that time. I think it should be, because you asked the question where the ability comes for the effect, right? I mentioned that it is something inbuilt. I think the answer should be that pachya, the reality, gets the ability to exist from the cause. That is like Janaka force. Like, why something arises? Because of the cause. So if someone asks, why, from where I get this ability to exist, I
drew it this kind of a diagram. So this ability, reduces and comes and start reduce, and suddenly it, reduces, then suddenly reduce, and I would not draw it to the till the bottom because it disappears. So this would be as the Banga level. This is the arising moment. Yeah, this is the existing moment. Exist means the, through the entire period it comes into declining. So I would not bring it to the bottom, right? It suddenly disappears. But at the last stage, there is a very huge declining of the ability. That is called the Banga stage. So now this ability to exist came from the Paccaya. That is how I would answer, right? It came from the Paccaya force. That is why it had the ability. So this ability, this support of the Paccaya was given to the Pachyupanna. From the Paccaya to Pachyupanna is given at the moment of arising. So it has a certain force given from the Paccaya. For example, when we throw a stone up, the force is given at the beginning only. Then it will decline because of the gravity and falls down. So likewise, the Paccaya gives the force, Pachyupanna gets the ability to exist from the Paccaya. And then, but while it is existing, it undergoes the force, a phenomenon called Jara. So it declines, right? So according to that 9.20, a conditioned reality possesses a certain ability to exist. This ability is seen as the speed of arising, The Pachyupanna obtains the ability to exist or speed of arising from the Paccaya. In other words, from the Paccaya Sati of the Paccaya. Right? So, I would like to change some point. This ability is also seen. Right? Please add that. It's not is seen. Is also seen as speed of arising. It means the speed of arising will stop, but the ability to live will exist. So ability to live is the main thing, but in the beginning we find it as the speed of arising. Yes, sir.
The suggestion to change the word speed into impulse.
Impulse. Okay, we can consider about that because the word given is the Vega, right?
Vega also has the translation of impulse.
Okay, we'll consider. Thank you for that.
And impulse. One question.
Yeah.
In the
diagram?
The same point, how to describe the same point?
This one?
Yeah.
It's the Banga level.
The beginning of that Banga, that point, how to describe?
That is means I would call it sudden, it decreases and its ability suddenly falls down. Increase, it comes into a rapid weakness. So that is why normally we say chitta, you can see the change. For example, if you go into the rupa, clashing the sensitivities. According to Abhidhamma, a rupa which is in the Banga stage doesn't clash with the, eye sensitivity. So in the Banga stage, it becomes really weaker. And the next thing I want to say is, when it is arising, this is the arising stage, this is the Banga stage, the entire is the persisting stage. For example, this is Upada, this is Banga, this is Titi. I'm talking the Titi as the entire thing. Right? So, when it arises, it doesn't mean it takes this much to arise. Upada means the period in which the impulse or the speed of arising still exists. The reality comes into entire existence in its full form at this moment. Reality doesn't take any time to come into its existence.
It means the nature of quality of chitta, it doesn't mean the quality of chitta comes into its completion at this moment. Chitta completely arises from the beginning and completely disappears from the end. It is not that chitta takes this much time and comes into a perfect chitta. No. It's not a growth. It suddenly appears and suddenly disappears. Then why do we say a rising moment and a passing away moment? So that is explainable, the speed of arising, ability to exist. Its ability to exist increases during this time. So we call it upada. At this level it stops and it starts to decline. And then it comes into a very rapid kind of a decline. Rapid kind of a decline. So that is the state which is called bhanga. So at the end of it, it completely disappears. It is not that it fades away. It's not that it slowly grows into its state. So it completely happens, completely disappears. Then why we decide this kana, periods of upada and bhanga, that is based on the ability to exist, speed, ability to exist, yes.
In the stage of bhanga,
yeah.
Why the speed to disappear suddenly?
That is something which is logically happens, can happen, right? That is the nature, right? I would call it the nature. So it's like that is how to do it.
You should have sensing additional thing.
What is that?
More than the needle stage.
Because when something is, it is obvious that when something is oppressed by a certain force, it becomes like...
If this force itself doesn't change.
What
this
do you mean?
Force always this level, when it suddenly disappears rapidly in the bhanga stage. Looks like the force increase. The disappearing force increase.
Because it is like it is proportion, right? Because when there is the ability to exist is there, when there is opposing force, right? It is slowly because I would call ability to exist is against the jara. There are two forces going on, right? So when this keeps on happening same way. But this decreases. So what happens? The ability to resist is declining. So when it declines, its effect is getting more and more. It's proportion. So what happens? When it comes to a certain level, the effect will be very powerful.
But you said that the ability to exist already finished at the top.
No. Ability to exist here means... That's right. Ability to exist. One part of the ability to exist. One part of the ability to exist is the upada vega. That's why I say also seen. So upada vega stops here, not the ability to exist. So upada ability to exist, the first part of the ability to exist, I would call it upada vega, the arising speed. Then that momentum will be stopped there, not the ability to exist. Right? So one ability to exist is the it exists throughout the entire thing. Right? But in the beginning part, we call it the upada vega. That will be stopped. But they are identical. I think you got the point, right? They are identical. And as your question comes, I would call this ability to exist is the resistance for jara. So when it declines, its effect, because if you consider it as a decline, which resistance for jara, so like the jara is the resistance for ability to exist is a resistance for jara and the other way. So when it declines, the jara will be oppressing in a greater manner, right? So then suddenly we have a rapid declining. I think you got the point, right? Right. So 9.20. Then paccaya obtains the ability to exist of or speed of arising from the paccaya, in other words, from the pachyupanna, paccaya satya of the paccaya. The last fundamental theory of this lecture, discussing the support of a paccaya which had occurred or existed or have been existing before, is given at the arising moment of the pachyupanna. So the support is given from another paccaya to this only at the moment of arising. Janaka satya is given at the moment of arising. A pachyupanna which has arisen does not need the support of a paccaya for its momentary titi or the bhanga. This is regarding which has arisen does not need the support of its pachya for its. So it's like what I mean is for the janaka function for its arising, the support is given from the other pachya for its, for the sake of its arising is given at the moment of arising. So if something arises due to another, so the support of this to this as a janaka to come into its existence is given at the moment of arising. After it has arisen, it doesn't need the support of a pachya to exist or to pass away. Because something which has arisen automatically exists and passes away. It is a natural law. So for this sudden arising, we need a pachya. Not for its decay and passing away. So these are the fundamentals that I would like to discuss. Nine fundamentals, I think, right? We discussed nine or eight. Seven, eight, nine. Yeah, we discussed nine fundamentals, right? So these are the points that I would like to discuss. If I summarize them again to conclude the lecture, every pachya and pachyupanna are different. The pachyupannas can never sustain. Conditioned realities can never sustain in their own. Then it always needs the support of pachya which has existed or has been existing before, occurred before. And there is no pachya which does not, for conditioned reality, pachyupanna, which does not get the support of another conditioned reality. And conditioned realities always arise in clusters. Theravadins advocate the idea of various causes supporting various effects, nana hetu nana pala. The ability of pachya to produce is pachyupanna is the pachya sati. Then, it is gain, the ability to exist is gain from the pachya. The pachyupanna gains this ability to exist from the pachya. Then, the support arising, for the support for the arising, the support of pachya which are occurred or existed have been existing before is given at the arising moment of the pachyupanna. For if I am talking about for the janaka pachyas, for the arising, right? Upatambaka and anupalaka pachyas, the force support is given at the moment of existing. But for the existence, if something has arisen because of a cause, that cause is necessary only for the arising, not for the existing and not for the passing. That is what I want to mean here. So these are the nine fundamentals that I could find in the causality of Theravadin. There can be some more. So this is what I understood, what I gained into the mind while writing. And the next lecture will be about another very basic four fundamentals about the pachyupanna. I'll be taking an entire lecture for the another four pillars about the causality, notions of causality. Yes. So if you have any questions. Yes.
About the conditioned realities need the support of conditioned reality.
Yeah.
I was wondering about the humans or like animals. At the time of understanding, our material, like rupa, need a kind of maybe like bits of father from like from father and bits of mother, and like kind of translation. That means like the support of rupa. But some neighbors or patterns are kind of at last this kind of sudden form. So like if any Theravada says it's kind of
So you are regarding which fundamental? I want to make it clarify more further.
It's like 9.15
and 1.6. If you take 9.15, the devas appear. I think you get his point, because animals and humans, they when they are want to be born, mothers get conceived with us of their offspring. So at that time, there is some part of the father and mothers from the body that becomes the base for our rupa. So therefore, all the beings arising on a certain base of the mother and father combination. So then he's asking, what about the devas? They just suddenly appear, right, out of the kamma. So still, if you go to the fundamental number 3, 9.15, so we are telling it needs the support of a fundamental pachya which has already existed. So if you are talking about deva, the first arising is kamaja rupa, its cause is the karma, right? So then a question comes, it needs that like it's already karma is there. So chittaja rupa, for example, what I mentioned was for the chittaja rupas to arise, there should be a santati, means already the rupa should have arisen. On such a generation of rupas, chittaja rupas are able to arise. If the kamaja rupas has not arisen before, chittaja rupas would not occur at that time. So that is like that is for the chittaja rupas, the mind-born matter. For the kamaja rupas, that chittaja rupas also need a support of a previously arisen rupas. So kamaja rupas arise suddenly, but its cause has already been made. There's the kamma. So that is why 9.15 is still valid. Then if you go to 9.16, support of a conditioned reality. So kamaja rupas appear to the devas, that kamaja rupa is produced by a kamma of past kamma, which is also a conditioned reality. So past kamma, after we do the kamma, I think last time we explained, it comes into a state of kamma samangita, the force of kamma, right? This force, actually, this force is the supporting for kamaja rupas. But in Theravadians, we don't distinguish as two things. We say the kamma itself is supporting the kamaja rupa. So kamma is a conditioned reality, right? It's a state of the conditioned reality, so it is supported by a conditioned reality. That's why we see, that's how we see. So that's how this fundamental is still valid for us. Any further questions? Okay. So we'll conclude.